Hello students, hope you are doing well. Every year the Karnataka B.Tech admission is conducted through two major entrance exams, that is KCET and KOMET KUGET. Through the admission process, the candidates are shortlisted for admission to B.Tech courses at numerous engineering colleges, universities and deemed universities in Karnataka state. Apart from the state-level entrance exam, some deemed universities also conduct their own entrance exams, while some also take direct admission. If you are also planning to get admission to B.Tech program at Karnataka, then it is very important for you to have the complete knowledge of the admission process before you apply. Hence, in today's video, we'll discuss all the important details pertaining to Karnataka B.Tech admission, such as admission, counseling, eligibility criteria, selection process, application process and other details. Karnataka B.Tech admission dates. If you want to check the latest dates for Karnataka B.Tech admission, then you can click the link provided in the video description, where you can find the complete schedule for the Karnataka B.Tech admission process. Now let us look at some of the important points related to Karnataka B.Tech admission. There will be two entrance exams conducted for Karnataka B.Tech admission, KCET and KOMET KUGET. While KCET will be conducted for admission to private and government colleges, KOMET KUGET will be conducted only for admission to private colleges. After the entrance exam is over, KEA will start KCET counseling and Consortium of Medical Engineering and Dental Colleges of Karnataka will start the KOMET K counseling. Some of the deemed universities in Karnataka also conduct their own entrance exam for admission. Some private colleges also accept direct admission on the basis of merit obtained by candidates in the qualifying examination. Now, let us look at the various entrance exams that are accepted by Karnataka colleges for B.Tech admission. The very first is KCET, which is the Karnataka Common Entrance Test, which is conducted by the Karnataka Examinations Authority, that is KEA. Next is the KOMET KUGET, which is Undergraduate Entrance Test, that is conducted by Consortium of Medical Engineering and Dental Colleges, Karnataka, on the behalf of Karnataka Unaided Private Engineering Colleges Association. KOMET KUGET is applicable for B.Tech admission in 190 private engineering colleges across the state. The third exam is JEE Main Exam, which is conducted by National Testing Agency, that is NTA. Only private engineering colleges and deemed universities that are private in Karnataka consider JEE Main score for admission to the B.Tech program. Apart from the above, deemed universities in Karnataka such as Manipal Deemed University, Christ Deemed University, PES Deemed University and others also conduct their own entrance test for B.Tech admission. The students who have a valid score in JEE Main or KOMET KUGET or KCET entrance exam can also apply for admission in such private deemed universities. Now, let us look at the eligibility criteria for Karnataka B.Tech admission. First, let us look at the academic qualification that are required for admission. Karnataka B.Tech applicants must have passed PUC, that is class 12th, with at least 45% of marks aggregate. The applicants must have studied class 12th with mathematics, physics and chemistry or biotechnology or biology or computer science as the main subjects. The applicants must have a valid KCET or KOMET KUGET or JEE Main score to secure B.Tech admission in Karnataka. Now, let us look at the domicile rules which will be applicable for the B.Tech admission based on KCET score or rank. The candidates who have completed their education in Karnataka, including their 12th, for a period of 7 years, are eligible for B.Tech admission in Karnataka through KCET. These students can compete for admission in government or private engineering colleges. The candidates who have studied only class 11th and 12th from Karnataka can also apply for B.Tech admission through KCET. Although the parents of the students must have studied in Karnataka for a minimum period of 7 years. The candidates whose parents' mother language is Kannada can also apply for B.Tech admission through KCET. These candidates must undergo a Kannada language test that will be conducted by KEA. The students will be assigned KCET exam centers in their respective districts. Now, let us look at the application process for Karnataka B.Tech admission, in which we'll first cover the application process for the entrance exam, that is KCET and co-mid-K UGET. The very first step is new user registration, for which you'll have to visit the official website and register yourself on the portal. The next step is to fill the form with all the required details and upload your image and signature and other documents in the prescribed format. The third step is that you'll have to pay the application fee using any of the payment options for the application form. And the last step is to take the printout of the application form and also get your principal's signature on the form. If you want to check the detailed information on how to apply for KCET, you can check our KCET application process video for all the important information. Now, let us look at the application process for the deemed universities. As we have already discussed, some of the deemed universities and colleges in Karnataka conduct their own entrance exam to shortlist the candidates. The candidates can follow the following steps for applying to deemed universities B.Tech admission in Karnataka. You will have to visit the official website of the respective college. On the homepage, you will find Apply Now link, which you have to click on. Then you will have to fill the form carefully with all the required details. Submit the documents as required in the prescribed format. Pay the application fee, download and save the form for future references. Now, let us look at the application process for colleges which take direct admission. Visit the official website of the respective college, click on apply for admission, fill the form with all the required details. If you have a valid score in any of the entrance exam, you will have to enter your score of that exam in the form. Submit the documents in the prescribed format, pay the fee and download and save the form for future reference. If you want to go for offline admission, you can visit the campus or you can fill the common application form on the given link and we'll take care of the rest process. Now, let us look at the Karnataka B.Tech admission process. First, let us look at the admission process through entrance exams. Through KCET, after the announcement of KCET entrance exam results, KEA will release the merit list for the candidates who are eligible to take part in the counseling process. All the candidates whose name appear in the merit list must attend the counseling as per the schedule. All the candidates in the merit list will have a rank or merit number based on which they can take part in the KCET counseling process. The KCET merit list will be prepared on the basis of marks obtained by the candidates in the KCET entrance exam. The percentage secured by the candidates in class 12th board exams will also be considered while preparing the merit list. Now, through co-mid-K UGET, which is another exam conducted by co-mid-K for candidates aspiring to get admission in private engineering colleges across the state. The rank will be allotted to each candidate based on his or her score in the entrance exam. All the candidates who have a valid co-mid-K UGET rank are also eligible to take part in co-mid-K UGET counseling process. Now, let us look at the admission process through deemed universities. The candidates who have applied for the admission will have to appear for the entrance exam that is conducted by the university. The date and venue of the same will be intimated to the candidates through the admit card. Based on the marks obtained by the candidates in the qualifying exam, the university level counseling process will be conducted, through which the candidates will be allotted seats for admission. Now, let us look at the admission process through direct admission. The candidates who fulfill the eligibility criteria will have to fill the application form. The shortlisted candidates will be further called to the campus where they will have to get their documents verified and pay the fee to complete the admission process. Now let us look at the average fee structure for B.Tech courses in various colleges of Maharashtra. For the government colleges, the average fee is 10,000 to 20,000 in rupees. And for the deemed / private colleges, the average fee ranges somewhere in between 50,000 to 1 lakh. Note that this is just the tentative fee structure for the B.Tech courses, and the actual fee may differ from this. Now, let us look at some of the popular B.Tech colleges in Maharashtra for admission. SCA Group of Institutions, Bangalore. Athriya Institute of Technology, that is AIT Bangalore. Acharya Institutes, Bangalore. Geetham deemed to be University, Bangalore. Ramaiah Institute of Applied Science, Bangalore. Jain University, Bangalore. Cambridge Institute of Technology, Bangalore. Krupanidhi Group of Institutions, Bangalore. Garden City University, Bangalore. Alliance University, Bangalore. ACS College of Engineering, Bangalore. And Bangalore Institute of Technologies, Bangalore. Common application form for college deco. The common application form, that is CAF, is a unique interface through which a student can apply to numerous colleges using a single window. Through the CAF platform, a student can apply to multiple colleges using a single application form, which is very easy for you. For B.Tech admission related assistance in Karnataka, you can fill the application form on our website, for which the link has been provided here. Our counselors will call you back and guide you through the B.Tech admission process in Karnataka, which will be easier for you. That's all for today. Thank you. For more information on B.Tech admissions, stay tuned to College Techo. You can also check the video description for more related articles. Also, do not forget to fill our common application form for admission related assistance. Thank you.
If you like this video, do like, share, comment, and subscribe to our YouTube channel.